Welcome back! My name is Baller Scuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1984. Today, we're going to talk about Karateka. The story of Karateka takes us to Jordan Mechner. Jordan Mechner is an American video game programmer. While attending Yale University, Mechner began writing video games for Apple II computers between his classes. Those included an Asteroids clone named Asteroid Blaster and a modified version of Asteroid Blaster named Death Bounce. Both of these games were rejected by publishers, however. Bruderbund, who had rejected Death Bounce, sent Mechner a copy of Choplifter, which we talked about in its own video. Mechner was inspired by Choplifter to pursue his own original game concepts. For 2 years, Mechner began focusing on a karate-themed game. Mechner was inspired by Japanese woodblock print art, the films of Akira Kurosawa, early Disney animated films, and silent pictures. Mechner has said that he thought of the game as a story-based game that had fighting elements instead of a fighting game itself. Mechner used a technique from film known as rotoscoping to animate his game. Rotoscoping is when a film is created of something, and then each frame has hand-drawn cartoons drawn over the top of the frame. This provides realistic movement to the animation of the cartoon. For the source material, Mechner filmed his karate instructor demonstrating various different moves. For the setting, Mechner decided on Japan, with the character moving between screens with different Japanese landscapes. The protagonist, though, would have blonde hair. This is said to have been inspired by Japanese preferences in manga, where many protagonists from adventure stories have blonde hair. Mechner's father, Francis Mechner, would create the soundtrack. Karateka is a fighting action game. The player plays as an unnamed hero. This hero must ascend a mountain into a fortress to rescue Princess Mariko. As the player moves the hero forward, enemies will appear, one per screen, to fight. The hero will enter a fighting stance and must punch, kick, and dodge to defeat each enemy before moving on to the next screen. The player and the enemy will both have their health displayed on the bottom of the screen, with one notch removed for each hit taken. If the player's health is depleted, the game is over and must be restarted. The player will also face obstacles, such as a hawk, a cliffside, and a falling portcullis. The game also includes cutscenes between screens. If the player is able to defeat all the other enemies, the hero will face off against the evil Akuma. Should the player defeat Akuma, Mariko will be rescued and the two will leave the fortress together. The game also comes with an Easter egg. If the user plays the reverse side of the game's disc, the game will play upside down. This was done as a joke by Mechner, who thought that it would cause the user to call tech support to ask why the game was upside down. After 2 years of work, Mechner submitted the game to Bruderbund while still a sophomore at Yale University. Bruderbund accepted and published Karateka for Apple II computers in December 1984. That is a brief backstory to Karateka. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game! Bruderbund Software presents a game by Jordan Mechner. Feels like a film already. Karateka. That's how I'm going to say it. It is the American pronunciation as far as I can tell. Copyright 1984 by Jordan Mechner. High atop a craggy cliff, guarded by an army of fierce warriors, stands the fortress of the evil warlord Akuma. Deep in the darkest dungeon of the castle, Akuma gloats over his lovely captive, the Princess Mariko. You are one trained in the way of karate, a karateka. Alone and unarmed, you must defeat Akuma and rescue the beautiful Mariko. Put fear and self-concern behind you. Focus your will on your objective, accepting death as a possibility. This is the way of the Karateka. And we get, you know, some sort of introduction. That is nice. And... ooh, a scene. Go to prison. He says it like, go to your room. Go to prison. We don't know much about the Princess Mariko, but that's pretty standard for the 80s. She is a princess, and she is beautiful, and she has a lovely silhouette. What does she do in time of crisis? Collapse. Just give up. But our hero is here, and he goes running. Gets into a fighting stance, and then starts fighting. I will say that the game is slow. The game's not necessarily programmed for computers very well, so, like, depending on how much is on the screen, and I'll show this as we go. I'm not controlling any of this, by the way. This is the demo. The game speeds up and slows us down, but that's been standard to this point. Ooh, high kicks. I will say that I'm going to pretty much exclusively use kicks because they have a longer range. And you don't get any bonus for using a punch, so I might as well just kick my way to victory. Like it's Taekwondo or something. All right, so we are looping around. Let's go ahead and get into the game ourselves. Let's see what I can do. I don't have high hopes. I can beat the first guy. After that, I tend to struggle. Let's approach the fortress. We get the hero's theme again, and we're ready to go. Now, it always seems to take me a little bit to get going here. I'm not sure what the issue is. I'm trying to switch stances, and nothing. Do I have to hit, like... All right, are we good now? Yeah, there seems to be, like, a button that I have to hit that's, like, K or something like that to say okay. All right, so you can punch, high punch... middle punch, low punch, those are Q, A, and Z, and then W, S, X will be kicks, high, middle, low. I believe that the middle one, it gives me the most range. Notice how quickly I attack now? Let's move forward and see if I can continue that. So we're up against a tutorial enemy here in front of Mount Fuji. Yeah, they kept on moving. I stopped. You can do three kicks before you have to put your foot down. So try to maximize that as best as you can. Take that for what you will. All right, there we go. Notice how we're starting to slow down a bit. One, two, three. Yeah, gonna get hit there, but there's one, just two more, and we're good. I do attack twice as fast as these guys. That will be the case until the final boss. And we've done it. But yeah, notice now, like, I can go way faster when there's nobody here. All right, this is where things get a little weird. So you want to switch to a running stance at this point and start moving. Go get him! And we're running. You want to do this because the further you get, the less enemies you're going to have to fight. That's the idea. So the further you get, the better. So once you defeat an enemy, you're... No. Ah! And the game's over. I hit the button as soon as I saw him on screen. It did not matter. This, I told you I struggle. So, we're gonna try that again, obviously. And, hopefully this time I cannot die. If you're not in a fighting stance when you get hit, you instantly die. So, be on the lookout for that. Alright, let's just go for mid kicks again. Try to get through this kind of quick. See, like, so much longer of a range on kicks than on punches. Then get back in there. Ah. Like, he's, for me, he is difficult to control. Come on. There we go. Get in my range. Yeah, when you're in a fight, no time limit, but once you're between fights, you're gonna wanna go kind of quickly. All right, not as good as the first time, but we're gonna do what I can here. Once again, like, I... Can we skip this? No. I need to stop and get into a fighting stance before he goes. So can I stop? I can. So let's try that instead. Once he's on screen, I stop. I hit left to stop. But yeah, this long hallway here, it, like, there's always going to be enemies. All right, we got there. God. You have to have such fast reactions to make that happen. You can see, like, I was instantly, like, in range of him. Come on. Just get in my kicking range. Okay. So far, so good, but, like I said, the hard part is honestly, like, stopping. I've tried switching stances, it doesn't seem to do the trick, so stopping by hitting left seems to be the way to go. No, just kick, 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 kick! There we go! Switch fighting stance! Run! So yeah, now somebody else is gonna run, so, like, the more that you cover, the better. Like, I feel like I barely stopped in time. Okay, there. Okay, out of your range. Okay. If you're just gonna keep punching, I'm just gonna keep kicking you. Range battle. Down you go. Did I lose some health there? What was that? Okay. Just stay back and kick. There's no reason for me to get in the pocket, so to speak, to use a boxing term. Like, just stick and move the whole way. Come on, no. Oh, he got me. He cheated. He's not allowed to kick. Since when do you guys know how to kick? I'm getting in your range. How dare you? Only I'm allowed to do the multiple kicks. You're using my strategy. I don't like this. I tried to, like, push forward and it bit me in the ass. So let's stay there. All right, get in the stance, move. All right. Fighting stance, just in time there. Come on, there we go. Stay back. But yes, I'm aware that Karateka, like, doesn't sound right for the name of this game, but I looked it up. Several people confirmed that is the American pronunciation. I believe that the Japanese pronunciation would be close to Karateka, something like that. But I'm told it's Karateka. All right, I'm not switching stances. I'm just gonna crawl my way through here. How dare you! Now I have to fight another enemy, and he's got so much more health than me because I didn't, like, recover health. Come on, get him. There we go. Keep going. I want to at least make it inside. Can I make it in the palace? Will this guy allow it? Come on, there we go. Yeah, I'm just three kicks in a row. Just constant three kicks. Once I have a good strategy, why would I change it? How dare you? How dare you back off? All right, two more, down you go, and through the door I go. She's still just so sad. All right, here you are, and then, oh, there. For whatever reason, I gotta hit K to get going. How dare you? All right, this might be the end. I at least made it in the hallway, and that makes me happy. So that's a good run for me. But yes, the character is blonde. And I understand, I'm a fan of manga, and yes, at the time, a lot of manga, the main characters had blonde hair. A lot of times they were German, though. If I'm getting health back, I will just hang out here and kick. Yeah, I'm getting health. But so is he. You know. There we go. Just stay back. Eh. Just constant sidekicks. I do know enough about martial arts to know that sidekicks can be effective. There was one pretty prominent fighter that I know of that used a lot of sidekicks, but mostly because they were by surprise. If I'm just spamming them out there, like, probably not gonna go well. Once again, like, I lost a bit of health there at the end. Yeah, shocker, he's sending more people my way. And we basically just rinse and repeat here. Of run for it. And there is the portcullis that we're going to have to time correctly. Uh-oh, I heard a hawk. No! The hawk got me! I didn't react quickly enough. Yeah, he sends the hawk out. The hawk is also instant death. What you're supposed to do is either punch or kick it, but I kind of waited too long and didn't get it in time. So that was a good run of Karateka, I feel. So that we're going to call that done. I made it, you know, a decent way. But of course, there is more that you can do. You can make it further inside and, of course, rescue the princess. I will say that there is kind of another little Easter egg. I don't know if I'm going to be able to show a clip of this, though. If you make it to the princess and you approach her in a fighting stance, she will kick you and you will lose. It's an instant death as well. You have to not be in fighting stance when you get to the princess. But that is the game played. And with the game played, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that I did have fun playing Karateka. I think it's a fun game. I think that Jordan Mechner was able to bring kind of the feel of a silent film and an Akira Kurosawa film into the game as a whole. Like, it feels like I'm playing some sort of silent Japanese film. That's what it feels like to me, although the characters do have blonde hair, but I understand the desire for that, considering the manga of the time. Most of the main characters did have blonde hair. A lot of them were German, so it's understandable, but it is a bit of an odd choice, considering the fact that you are going through a Japanese landscape, and we'll talk a little bit more about that, but outside of that, I feel that the game works very well. It is a little bit slow, and I think that has a bit to do with the rotoscoping technique. The rotoscoping technique does provide very fluid animations, but it also slows things down a little bit. How the character runs is also a little weird for me, at least how they start running. You kind of lean forward, and then your legs start going. That one's a little off for me, but I've seen people do it, so I'm not surprised that I wouldn't be surprised if Jordan Mechner's karate instructor also just kind of did the same thing. But overall, I think it's a fun experience. You have to have very fast reactions at times, and then other times it's just like, all right, let's just kick my way to victory. So the gameplay could be improved upon. But ultimately, for 1984, for a single developer especially, I think this is a good game, and I think it holds up pretty well. I think that it would be more fun to watch somebody who is very skilled at the game and can guarantee, yeah, I'll make it through without dying at all. I think that would be a more fun experience than actually trying to do it yourself, especially if you have never picked up the game before. Kind of going in fresh, it can be a little frustrating at points. If you know, the hawk or falcon, I think it was a hawk, comes at you and you're just not ready, you don't hit the button fast enough, and there you go. That's how I died. But you can also easily die not getting into the fighting stance in time, and that is a hard thing to do if you don't know, like, all right, I have to have the button ready right now, that kind of thing. Yeah, I think that the fighting mechanic could be improved upon. Obviously, in real life, punches aren't, you know, don't have the range of kicks. So I don't necessarily know how to fix that. But of course, we will see games that fix it where punches and kicks have much more similar ranges so that it will be better for you to punch at times and kick at times, instead of this one where it seems that the best way to go is always to kick because it always has a better range. Of course, I would love to see ducking and jumping and all that kind of stuff more ingrained into this game. There's a lot of fighting mechanics that I think could be improved upon with this game, but like I said, overall, it is a fun experience. It's more about the plot, just like Jordan Mechner kind of said. It's more about the plot and the feel than it is about the actual gameplay itself, but I think the gameplay holds up fairly well. I think the graphics hold up fairly well as well. Obviously, the Apple II is kind of limited in how detailed the sprites and the rotoscoping can be. So it didn't age particularly well because it's supposed to look realistic, and as time goes on, things that are supposed to look realistic will look less realistic. So by today's standards, it doesn't look realistic, but I think that it still conveys what it's supposed to. I think that the game's graphic holds up pretty well, and I think the music is actually really good. It feels like a film or a silent film. You know, you have the different, not necessarily jingles, but you have the different kind of themes for the villain, the princess, the hero, all that kind of stuff. And I think that is done very well. So overall, I think the game holds up pretty well. I think that this is a game that would be enjoyable for people that are interested in the history of fighting games, in the history of kind of story-driven games, or interested in the games, especially by Jordan Mechner himself. If you're interested in kind of in adventure games, it's worth checking out. Like I said, it might be more fun to watch somebody else who is very skilled at the game just kind of blast through the game than it would be for somebody fresh that to play it, I should say. But honestly, it is worth checking out. It is a good game. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, it proved to be popular. In total, across all different versions of the game, Karateka sold over 500,000 copies. Critics at the time were also positive about the game. In particular, the game's technical achievements for visuals and animation, as well as the gameplay, were praised. Several critics at the time, though, criticized the use of blonde characters in a Japanese setting. Karateka would see ports and remakes. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. As for Jordan Mechner, he would use the success of Karateka to continue creating video games. We will hear from Jordan Mechner again. As for Bruderbund, they would continue to be a major force in the American computer game publishing industry. We will hear from Bruderbund again as well. That will do it for the story of Karateka for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we get rolling.